Well, I'm so sorry I'm late. Hello, everybody.
Iris was invited?
Yeah, it was Josie's idea. No one had the heart to fill her in.
As long as she brought an expensive present.
Iris, it's so good that you could be here.
I'm sorry I'm late. I had business at the Coreys.
No.
Hear that?
I better call Rachel.
Yeah. Well, where should I put this?
I'll take it. Couldn't somebody take your coat for
me? Oh, thanks. My, everything looks very, festive, doesn't it?
It does, doesn't it?
Oh, Donna, I'm so pleased you're here. I wanted to talk to you. I've been meaning to call you.
Iris, why don't I get you some champagne?
Yes. Now then, about this awful mugging.
Word does get around, doesn't it?
Oh, you poor old thing. It must have been an absolute nightmare. Ada, how are you?
Never better, Iris. Heavens to Betsy, we're all out of shrimp puffs.
I'll give you a hand, Ada.
Thank you.
I suppose it could have been worse.
Oh, yeah, much worse. But you're so courageous, up and about and partying already.
Iris? Well, there's no point in dwelling on it.
Thank you. Isn't she, amazing?
Well, yes, you are. You're very brave, Mrs. Hudson.
Surprised to see you here, Frankie.
Why? Charlene's my aunt.
Well, Lucas told me you were deathly ill this morning.
Everyone, I think that we should start having my mom open some of her presents. What do you say?
I want to eat.
You've been eating since you got here, John.
Mama, you come over here and you said
that's a good idea.
Yeah.
Look, I had to go shopping for the shower today, so don't say anything to Lucas, okay?
Listen, everybody, I'm going to put on some present opening music.
Please do. Okay.
Good idea.
There you go.
Now, this is for me. Now, if this doesn't fit or something, you can take it back. I got it at that fabulous boutique. Oh,
to die for that.
Sacrifices well.
Oh, Felicia, I love it. You do. Thank you so much.
Can I wear that?
No. You can. Are you ready for your next one?
I hope so. Now, Josie, you keeping track of these, please? Oh, no. Now, who's this from?
Me. And read the card.
All right. All right. Hold on. Okay. Special card to be. Too short of me.
Not out loud. It's too short.
So sorry.
So sensitive.
Here, let me give you this. Okay. All right, here we go.
Oh my God.
I don't believe this.
Why don't you leave the room, in fact? Hey, come on, everybody, just a nightgown, okay? Just a very little nightgown. Listen, why don't you keep it in the box and pass it around so we can all take a look at it? Okay. So where are all the practical gifts, like, you know, toasters, microwaves, refrigerators, bank accounts? This is a luxury shower, though, you know, for the honeymoon. Like I said, I hate practical gifts.
All right.
Ready?
I guess so. Here we go. Now,
satin. She's been beautiful.
So subtle.
These are, I've never even touched satin sheets. Who are these from?
They're for me.
They're beautiful.
I hope they're all right. I mean, the color and everything.
Donna, they're absolutely perfect. Thank you so much. Thank you. This is just, it's too much.
Well, you better get used to it because there's a lot more stuff here.
Well, first I think that we should eat that food before it gets cold. So everyone
just help us. Do you
want to eat it?
Yeah, right.
Get him some meatballs.
I want some meatballs.
Hey, I'm so glad you called a halt.
Well,
I needed a little break.
I called a halt to it all because I wanted to give you my present in private.
Okay.
I hope you like it.
I cannot imagine not liking this.
Okay, can you have that? Let's see.
Oh, Josie.
I know I should have given you lingerie or something like that.
Josie, this is perfect.
I just wanted to know how much this is really hard for me.
You're doing great. Keep going.
I just want you to know how much you mean to me. How much I want you to be happy.
Joe's, I can't imagine being happier than I am right now.
I wonder where Rachel is. There was no answer when I called.
Well, maybe she got bogged down at work.
Yeah, maybe.
Hi, everybody. Is my brother the doctor here?
It's a bridal shower, Michael.
That's right. Yeah. No men allowed.
Yeah, well, what am I doing here?
I don't know.
What are you doing here?
Come on. I got to talk to you.
Is everything all right?
Everything's fine. I just like to... Come on, let's go. I'll talk to you outside.
Yeah, no problem.
See ya.
No, wait a second. Where are you going? Where are you taking
We're going
you?
Out.
What do you mean
out? See you later.
Oh, okay.
Save some food.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Now, what do you suppose that was all about?
Think about it, Charlene.
Think about it, Charlene.
Whoa!
Oh, good.
John's gonna get a little shock himself.
Yeah.
Do
it. I hope he's the only one.
I told Sam that I'm going with Evan to New York.
What? What are you talking about?
Mom, somebody from the creative side has to go.
Who made this decision?
I did, this morning.
Without consulting me?
Well, I was going to.
When?
Mom, I want to go.
I don't care if you want to go. You're not going. You're staying here.
Why?
I need somebody in this office.
You don't want me to go because you don't trust me, right? You think that I'm stupid enough to let something happen with Evan. Don't you?
Put you up to this?
Mom, this is a business trip. Don't you think the two of us could be friends?
No.
Why not?
Because sometimes it's just not possible, that's all. You should know that by now.
Do you know that?
What does that mean?
That means that you refuse to believe that Evan and I could be friends.
I just said that.
Yeah, that's exactly what you're expecting the rest of us to believe about you and Mitch.
I loved her first, and she loved me.
Give me the swan.
You remember that, don't you, Mitch? First love? It's like you're on fire. You remember, with Rachel?
Give me the swan, Lucas.
So you can give it back to Rachel and collect your reward?
They're gonna put you away.
Oh, come on, you can't bluff a bluffer. You didn't see me steal this.
So what are you saying, you're innocent?
That's right, I'm innocent.
Give me the swan. What's the problem, Lucas?
Nothing. I just wanted to clean up first. You want the swan?
I want the swan.
Okay.
Still no answer.
Did you try his doctor, my chief?
Yes, answering service.
Well, then he's probably on his way here, man. I wouldn't worry about it.
Okay.
Oh, there's probably him now. Come on, let's go see.
Ooh, and here he is. That's not Dad.
No.
Hello, Matthew.
Hi.
Cecile, what are you doing here?
Looks like you're having a party.
Bachelor party.
Yeah.
Beth, no women.
No. It's supposed to be a surprise party.
Well, I love surprises. You know that, Jamie.
Wouldn't want to make you feel uncomfortable.
That's very sweet of you, Matthew. But I feel right at home, actually.
Cecile, why are you here?
To see Cass.
About what?
A legal thing. Not that it's any of your business, Jamie, but I need to speak to Cass about being the executor of the Mackenzie Corey Memorial Fund. I did call his office and spoke to a nice young man there.
It was,
he told me...
Me that you talked to.
Oh, well, hello in person, nice young man.
My pleasure.
You see, there really is a reason that I'm here, Jamie.
You want to talk business in the middle of a stag party.
And you did say on the phone that this was an emergency.
Yeah.
I'm sometimes guilty of speaking in extremes.
You do everything in extremes, Cecile. Now, look, this is John Hudson's party, and you really can't say.
So, does that mean everybody here is a bachelor? Like him?
Excuse me.
Just put in your antenna, Cecile. That's Evan Bates. He's a cousin of mine and Frankie's.
Yours and Frankie's?
Yes.
Huh, very interesting.
Wait, where are you going?
Done, man.
Look, this can't wait. Listen, use my place with my blessing, okay? I've got work piled up this high on my desk, and I've got a lot of work to do, okay? And I hope John understands.
Sure.
I got a big trip planned to New York tomorrow, so if you just excuse me and just...
Arnie Cooper.
See you.
We haven't met.
Well, that wasn't by my doing.
I'm Cécile de Poulignac.
Evan Bates, nice to meet you.
And you're Frankie Frame's cousin.
Well, actually, I'm a lot of people's cousin. The Frames are a big family.
Yes, I met her the other night.
Did you?
Very interesting woman.
Did you come here to talk to me about Frankie?
Are you too close?
Actually, I just met her a couple months ago.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Actually, I was a little surprised to see you come in here.
Well, I'm not one to plan ahead.
Yeah? Well, this is my apartment, and I didn't invite you.
Your apartment, and you're leaving.
That's right. I have a lot of work tonight. Sorry about that.
So am I. It was a distinct pleasure to meet you, Mr. Bates.
Call me Evan.
Evan. Au revoir, Evan.
A bientôt.
Come on, Cécile. Put on your coat and I'll walk you to your car.
Jamie, I haven't even seen Cass yet. I have to talk to him. He will be here soon.
Well, I heard he was invited. Yes, come on.
Well, now tell me something. Do you see much of Cass? I mean, are you friendly at all?
Why?
Is he seeing a lot of Frankie?
Do you really expect me to discuss Cass's personal life with you?
Dear Jamie.
Yes.
Always were quite the worrier, weren't you? Very serious. Now, are those new worry lines I see on your face?
Believe me, they appear the moment you walked in the door.
Oh, stop it. Now, I know what it is. It's your divorce. It can be so stressful, I know.
Yes, you ought to know.
I met Victoria.
Oh, I wish I'd seen that.
Is she giving you a hard time?
I can handle her.
I just want you to know one thing. I will always be here for you.
That's very touching.
Really, Jamie, if you need to talk, if you need to, a heart-to-heart with someone, I'm here.
Thanks very much.
He's a jolly good fellow, and nobody can deny, and nobody can deny, which nobody can deny, for he's a jolly good fellow.
Mitch and I are friends.
I know, you keep saying that.
You just let me finish. He's helped me get through a very difficult time, and I am very grateful to him, and that's as far as it goes.
Fine.
How could you possibly think I could even look at another man after the kind of love that your father and I shared?
Sorry.
I don't take love that lightly, and neither should you.
I don't.
I hope not. Because love, real love, not infatuation, not lust, but real love takes a lot of caring, a lot of work, unselfishness, loyalty. Those are strong qualities, Amanda. Do you have that kind of strength?
Will you go to New York and play with me?